फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर फिजिक्स क्लास। एंड टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज रिंग डायग्राम बाय मल्टीपल मिरर सिस्टम। बाय मल्टीपल व्हाट आई मीन इज टू मिरर इंक्लाइंड एट एन एंगल, इंक्लाइंड एट सम एंगल थीटा। टू लर्न फर्स्ट यू हैव टू रियलाइज हाउ एन इमेज ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर्म बाय मिरर। लेट्स टेक वन प्लेन मिरर एंड यू ऑल विल यूज दिस मेथड व्हेनेवर यू हैव टू ड्रॉ अ रे डायग्राम इन केस ऑफ मिरर। दिस इज अवर ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर्म। We all know that for an image to be formed, we need two reflected rays, and for two reflected rays, we need two incident rays. Let me take a proper diagram. This looks good. First thing that you have to remember is first ray, first incident ray. Will always be perpendicular to the mirror. That way it will be very easy for us to draw. First ray will be perpendicular to the mirror, and in this case whenever a light ray incidents perpendicularly onto a mirror, it goes back on its own path. See, this was our incident ray. After incidenting on the mirror, it retraces itself. That means it goes back on its own path. So this is our reflected ray one. Let's take another ray. This is our incident ray two. Now we have to draw normal. It will look like this. So this is our reflected ray two. This is our reflected ray one. They are not going to cut above the mirror, so we have to turn them back like this. And image will be formed opposite side of the mirror. We have read this, we have studied this. Now, what are the properties of image? Its distance from mirror is same as object distance from mirror. It is virtual in nature and its size will be same as that of object. Now you have to perfect this method whenever you want to draw the ray diagram of an object. Now we are going to use this in this case. Now we have to suppose this diagram is quite big. Suppose we have two plane mirrors inclined at an angle and here. This is our plane mirror M1. This is our plane mirror M2. And angle between them is 90 degrees. We have studied in last class. And suppose an object is placed between them. Somewhere location doesn't matter. So we have studied in last class that number of images, first we have to calculate 60 degree by theta. Theta in this case is 90 degree. So 60 degree by 90 degree, that is 4. Since it is an even number, our number of images formed will be 4 minus 1 equals to 3. So in this case, 3 images will be formed. What we know that a plane mirror forms a single image of a single object. But in this case, we have 2 plane mirrors. But number of images are 3. So we have to say this. First, we are going to make image of this object from this mirror. For that we will take incident wave 1. This is our incident wave 1. It is incidenting perpendicularly on the mirror M2, and whenever a ray incidents perpendicularly on the mirror, it goes back on its own path. So this ray will just go back where it came from on the same path. See, this is our incident ray 1 and this is our reflected ray 1. To make an image, we always need two reflected rays. This is only one reflected ray. So, we are taking second incident ray, that is I2. Now, after reflection from mirror, it will look something like this. See, this is our incident ray 2, and after reflection from mirror M2, it again incidents on mirror M1. But we will see that for after some while. In this case, we got our reflected ray. Let's see this again. I1 was our first incident ray, which was incidenting perpendicular onto mirror M2, and after reflection from mirror, it goes back on its own path. I2 is our second incident ray, and after reflection from mirror M2, we get our second reflected ray, that is R2. R1 and R2 are our two reflected rays. We have to explain them then. See. O1. This is our first image. And this image is made by mirror M2. That was very simple, just like previous question. Now, we will take another ray from object O, but this time on mirror M1. Since this ray is also incidenting perpendicular to this mirror, it will also go back on its own path like this. Physics in this ray and this ray is same. Now we have to take another ray. Okay, forget this. First, let's complete this part. I1 was perpendicular, goes back. I2 after reflection becomes R2. Now R2 is incidenting on this mirror, and after reflection it will go something like this. So this ray is reflected twice. Once from mirror M2. Then again from mirror M1. Okay, now if it won't incident on this mirror, so this is our final ray. Now once again, we took an incident ray that incident from mirror M1 and goes back on its own path. Again, we have to take one more ray, something like this. After reflection, this ray will incident on this mirror. Again, after reflection, it will go like this. I know this diagram is a little bit complicated, but after some time, you will get a word of it. Think? Okay, now we have to make another diagram. Another image. This and this are our reflected rays. After extending them back, So we know that total of three images have to be formed. But till now we have got only one and two images. Where is the third image? We know an image is formed when two reflected rays cut each other or seem to cut each other. Where are the other reflected rays? See, this is also reflected ray. But what is the difference between this and this? This ray is reflected once only. But we got this ray when this incident ray first got reflected from mirror M1, then got reflected from mirror M2. So this is our reflected ray, but we got this after second reflection. That is true in this case also. That is true for this ray too. We got this ray when this incident ray got reflected from mirror M2, then again from mirror M1. So these rays are identical because they got reflected twice from the mirror. These rays, they are identical because they got reflected once from the mirror. So what we have to do? Now extend them back again. And this is our third image. Okay. I know this looks a bit more complicated, but there is no help to it. The whole process is not necessary. You have to understand the crux of it, which is three images will be formed. This one and this one are formed from first reflection, and this image is formed from second reflection of the rays. It doesn't matter if you don't understand this, you have to understand the result that total of three images have to be formed. And we will do this one more. See, this image is formed by mirror M2, this image is formed by mirror M1, and they are at the same distance from the mirror as an object. The third image is formed at the junction of the mirror, where they are joined. Okay. Let's make a Mickey Mouse. Mickey Mouse is our object here. Okay. This is mirror M2, this is mirror M1. Now this face or smiley will act as an object. And total of three images will be formed from mirror M2 and mirror M1. One will be just beneath it, like this. One will be at the left end of this. And third will be at the junction of these mirrors. So three images will be formed like this. One will be here, one will be here, and one will be here. But I have already told you before that mirror does a phenomena that is called lateral inversion. Up becomes down, down becomes up, left becomes right, and right becomes left. Suppose this is our ear number 1 and this is our ear number 2. So image will be formed in this way. There will be no change. But what will change? This was ear number 1. So in image, on the right side will be ear number 2. In object, left side was ear number 2. And this will become ear number 1. This phenomenon is called lateral inversion. Right becomes left, left becomes right. Right eye will become left eye, left eye will become right eye. So this is our image number one. One image will be formed beneath the mirror. So what will happen there? Up will become down and down will become up. Our Mickey Mouse will look like this. Up became down and down became up. Here left became right and right became left. But this is our object. This is our first image. This is our second image. Where will be the third image? I told you third image is formed at the junction of mirror. Somewhere here. Again tomorrow.